On New Year's Eve, December 31st, 2011, Supreme Master Television was honored to invite Supreme Master Ching Hai to share a message via video conference to the audience throughout the world and universe. Graciously expressing her heartfelt wishes for an auspicious new year, Supreme Master Ching Hai reminded all beings that we are all connected and must therefore renew our aspirations toward loving actions and noble ideals. We now invite you to watch the live conference entitled A New Year of Compassion, Special Message from Supreme Master Ching Hai, which took place on Saturday, December 31st, 2011 in Los Angeles, California, USA.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Hey.
Hi, Master.
Everyone, let's make a toast to Master.
Happy Vegan New Year!
Please sit down, please sit down. Take a rest. You've been working all day. Yeah, sit down. Thank you. I cannot stand up because if I stand up, you won't see me. I try. Let you have a look. I want to stand up to greet you, but if I stand up, you only see my stomach. I did stand up. Yeah? Okay.
Yes, Master.
How are you guys? Good?
Yes.
Most beloved Master, we are so honored to be graced by your presence, Master, and you look so beautiful as always.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
We feel so incredibly blessed to be able to spend New Year's Eve with you. Thank you so much, Master, and Happy Vegan New Year.
Happy Vegan New Year to you and to all who are watching to the world. Happy Vegan New Year.
Happy Vegan New Year,
Master.
We try our best to contact you because my situation is not always favorable for this kind of conference and contact.
Yes, Master.
Okay. All right. Is there anything you want to say to me? Chocolate?
Yes, Master. Master, for the upcoming New Year 2012, may we respectfully invite you to share a message with our audience around the universe.
Oh, right. Okay, that's all you want, huh? Good, we do that. First of all, I want to wish all of you and the audience and the world a very, very happy, lucky, vegan New Year. And I think I have tried everything. I don't know if anything else I should say because I have said a lot already. It's not what I say, it's what we apply, huh? And it's not only what I say, it's also if anyone listen or not. But nevertheless, it's New Year, and since you request, we say something. Okay?
Thank you, Master.
One more time, won't hurt. Buddha has already said everything. Buddha has tried his best to sacrifice everything for us. And Jesus gave up his life for the world. Guru Nanak, Mahavira, Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, etc. So many masters, so many great saints and sages have told us everything already, New Year or Old Year?
Yes, Master.
It's not just a New Year that we should be happy and celebrate, but we should start like a new resolution. Yeah, new lifestyle. If we haven't tried it in the past year, every time New Year, we should like make a vow to begin our new life. Everything that we don't like about the past year, from ourselves or from our environment, we should change. Yeah? Mm. All the sages have told us already to live and let live, to love and love all beings at oneself. This is a time to begin to reflect whether we have done that love or not. The Buddha and Jesus and all the Master have told us to live a compassionate life. Yet when we commemorate Buddha's birth even at that day, many Buddhists still have lunch eating dead animal flesh. At Christmas, or often any prophet's birth celebration, many still do the same. Killing and making suffering for humans and animals. Because humans misunderstood all the loving message of the masters, either knowingly or unknowingly. All other sages and saints have endured hardship, sacrificed all to remind us of a more compassionate way of life.
Vegetarianism in religion.
The Baha'i Faith. Regarding the eating of animal flesh and abstinence therefrom, know thou of a certainty that, in the beginning of creation, God determined the food of every living being, and to eat contrary to that determination is not approved. Selections from the Baha'i Writings of Some Aspects of Health and Healing.
Buddhism. All meats eaten by living beings are of their own relatives. Lankavatara Sutra. Also, after the birth of the baby, care must be exercised not to kill any animal in order to feed the mother with meaty delicacies, and not to assemble many relatives to drink liquor or to eat meat, because at the difficult time of birth, there are innumerable evil demons, monsters, and goblins who want to consume the smelly blood. By ignorantly and adversely resorting to the killing of animals for consumption, they bring down curses upon themselves, which are detrimental to both the mother and the baby. Kasithigarbha Sutra. Be careful during the days immediately after someone's death, not killing or destroying, or creating evil karma by worshipping or offering sacrifice to demons and deities, because such killing and slaughtering committed, or such worship performed, or such sacrifice offered, would not have even an iota of force to benefit the dead, but would entwine even more sinful karma into previous karma, making it even deeper and more serious. Thus, delay his rebirth to a good state. Karma means retribution. Kasithigarbha Sutra.
Gaudai. The most important thing is to stop killing, because animals also have souls and understand like humans. If we kill and eat them, then we owe them a blood debt. Teachings of the Saints.
Christianity. Meats for the belly, and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Holy Bible.
And while the flesh was yet between their teeth, ere it was chewed, the wrath of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord smote the people with a very great plague. Holy Bible.
Confucianism. All men have a mind which cannot bear to see the sufferings of others. The superior man, having seen the animals alive, cannot bear to see them die. Having heard their dying cries, he cannot bear to eat their flesh. Mencius. Essenes.
I am come to end the sacrifices and feasts of blood, and if ye cease not offering and eating of flesh and blood, the wrath of God shall not cease from you. Gospel of the Holy Twelve.
Hinduism. Since you cannot bring killed animals back to life, you are responsible for killing them. Therefore, you are going to hell. There is no way for your deliverance. Adilila.
He who desires to augment his own flesh by eating the flesh of other creatures lives in misery in whatever species he may take his birth. Mahabharata Anu.
Islam. Allah will not give mercy to anyone except those who give mercy to other creatures. Hadith.
Do not allow your stomachs to become graveyards of animals. Hadith.
Jainism. A true monk should not accept such food and drink as has been specially prepared for him involving the slaughter of living beings. Sutra Katanga.
Judaism. And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eateth any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and will cut him off from among his people. Holy Bible. Blood meaning flesh.
Sikhism. Those mortals who consume marijuana, flesh, and wine, no matter what pilgrimages, fasts, and rituals they follow, they will all go to hell. Guru Granth Sahib.
Taoism. Do not go into the mountain to catch birds and nets, nor to the water to poison fishes and minnows. Do not butcher the ox that plows your field. Tract of the Quiet Way.
Tibetan Buddhism. The offering to the deities of meat obtained by killing animate beings is like offering a mother the flesh of her own child, and this is a grievous failure, the supreme path of discipleship.
Zoroastrianism. Those plants I, Ahura Mazda, or God, rain down upon the earth to bring food to the faithful and fodder to the beneficent cow. Avesta.
Everybody knows that vegetarian diet is good for health and to save the planet. They will be awakening their own great, compassionate, loving self-nature, and then their level of consciousness will rise up automatically, and they will understand more than they ever did, and they'll be closer to heaven than what they are right now. I hope in the new year, all of us try to vow to do the best as well, to follow their example, to repay their kindness, to save our lives and the lives of all on the planet. It is our duty, actually, to do that.
Yes, Master.
Because you see, like, disaster happens everywhere nowadays. Every time you turn on any television, it's only about war, disaster, most of the time. It just breaks my heart to even watch TV. You see, we cannot say that, okay, in my area, in my country, there's no disaster. I celebrate New Year, nothing happened. It happens elsewhere. And you will always ask me, like everyone else would ask me, why it happened in Africa? Why it doesn't happen where I live? Yes, because we are all one. You see, the whole world community is connected with each other. So disaster doesn't necessarily break out in a particular place. It breaks out elsewhere or somewhere that is vulnerable, somewhere it has already some potential for disaster or vulnerable areas. For example, if you eat something not well, not good, then the pimple break out where? Break out where? Tell me. On your face, right?
Yes, Master.
It's not breaking out maybe in your stomach or on your hand or your mouth because you keep putting the food in it, but it breaks out in your face, for example. Or if you have digestion problem in the stomach, it affects your brain, you have headache. Yeah?
Yes, Master.
So, yeah, that's right. Or even if a mother smoke while pregnant, the fetus inside her womb suffer from poor blood circulation, for example. Or when he's born, he has sometimes sudden infant death syndrome, as we all know very well. And if the parents are smoking in the house, the children sometimes have trouble. Even if he doesn't have too much trouble in the youth, after 50 years of age, he has trouble with his lung, his breathing system, etc. So the consequences is a long-term effect.
Some of the tragic tolls of tobacco. 5.4 million smoking-related deaths per year worldwide. Tobacco use kills one person every 6 seconds. Smoking-related costs, $193 billion US annually in the United States alone. Depression. Light and mild cigarettes just as harmful. causes cancer and diseases in animal companions, harms lung cell DNA that regulates breathing, speeds the aging process, toxic residues of third-hand smoke, heart disease, coronary thrombosis, cerebral thrombosis, kidney failure, cancer, mouth, liver, breast and colorectal cancer, lung cancer, esophagus cancer, kidney cancer, bladder cancer, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, emphysema, bronchitis, stroke, impotence.
Additional harms for exposure to secondhand smoke, 600,000 deaths worldwide each year.
Childhood arteriosclerosis, leading to heart attacks and strokes in adulthood.
Sudden infant death syndrome, more than 80% of the babies who die are exposed to secondhand smoke.
Infertility, miscarriages and premature deliveries. Childhood asthma, bronchitis, ear infection, cleft lip or palate. Hyperactivity and aggression in asthmatic boys, circulatory problems in women.
Lung damage in children leading to adult emphysema. Lung cancer in non-smoking restaurant servers. Hearing loss across all frequencies. Childhood behavioral problems when exposed while in the womb.
Plus more. For help quitting, please visit.
For more urgent information, please visit suprememastertv.com/killers.
So if we continue with the killing of men and animals, then disaster will break out elsewhere or somewhere or right where we live, personally affecting us, our family, or the surrounding or the neighborhood. Remember in the Bible the story of David the king. He forced the wife of one of his subordinates to become his wife and then killed the husband. And heaven punished disaster for his country. It is even stated that in the Bible. How many Christians would consider that as the law of cause and retribution? That is the law of cause and retribution. That is the what you sow, so shall you reap. So there's no need to say it's only Buddhist doctrine that say that, or Jainism, or Sikhism, or Hinduism, or even Islam. All the prophets have told us to do good things, be good. But would we try now to follow their example? Since this may be the last time I have the chance to speak to all of the world audience via multi-channel television, and in this way, I might as well tell you all this. Because we are all one, so there's no differentiate where the problem will break out. So if somebody do some bad things here, the problem might break out elsewhere. So do not keep asking me why disaster happen in poor country. People in poor countries suffer more because it's vulnerable area. Just like your face is more sensitive. So if your digestion system are not good, you have pimples all over your face. Yeah, your face doesn't eat anything. Your face doesn't put anything on it. Just nice and nutritious cream or not. Even then, the pimples break out on your face. Because you don't have enough purity in the blood. Because you have digestion problem. Because you eat too many things that is not good, not constructive to your blood purity. Yeah? Okay?
Yes, Master.
And sometimes, yes, you eat something in your mouth, but your liver have problem. You see that?
Yes, Master.
And sometimes you just have a cut here, yeah? Or somebody have a cut here, but then he has infection elsewhere, yeah? It goes into his liver. He smoke here on his mouth, but his lung will have cancer. For example, like that, huh? And if he eat meat too much or too much fat and all that, the heart will have problem. It's because the whole body is one. The whole body is one. Similarly, the whole world is one. So disaster will happen here or will happen there, it's the same. It's the same. It's a warning for humanity. It is the consequences of the action that we took. I have also done my best all these years to try to remind everyone the same message, that we have to be loving and kind. Probably I have said more than enough what should be said. So it's up to everyone now to decide the course of their life, which is also linked to all others' lives and to the survival of this planet. I do pray at the New Year Eve that everyone choose the wise path of the saints and sages, which is love and respect for all beings on the planet, so that they themselves will also be loved and respected in heaven, now and hereafter. By the way, I'm thanking all of you who wrote to me about the change of your life, that you have turned back to your own self, glorious nature, original nature, which is loving kindness. I thank all of you who bettering your own life and in turn bettering the world by cleaning up society with your own example, by like quit smoking, stop gambling, refrain from intoxicants, choosing a vegan, helping others in any way you can, etc. I thank all of you for all that, the audience and the world people, the leaders and citizens of the world, all alike. I pray God to bless your sincere effort to be good and do good and continue in this noble way of life.
Some of the tragic tolls of alcohol. 2.5 million alcohol-related deaths per year worldwide.
1 in 6 deaths on the road in the UK are caused by drunk driving.
In Australia alone, 70% of adults are negatively impacted by another's drinking, with 43% affected by physical or verbal abuse. Over 100 British children each week call a hotline to express concern about their parents' alcohol and drug use. Cost of alcohol-related illnesses, $186.4 billion US dollars in the United States. £2.41 million for prescription medications each year in England, UK, with overall health costs in the billions. 210 to 665 billion US dollars globally. Disease. Higher amounts of alcohol increase the cancer risk. Even half a glass of wine daily increases the risk of mouth or throat cancer by 168%. Cancer of the liver, breast, colon, esophagus, rectum. Linked to 20% of breast cancer cases.
Liver disease, cardiovascular disease, metal toxicity.
Sleep pattern disturbance, including frequent awakening and reduced rest.
Brain damage, amnesia and dementia. Brain shrinkage. Organ failure, heart, liver, kidneys, stomach, pancreas, eyes.
Birth defects. Children afflicted by anxiety and depression, mental retardation, fetal alcohol syndrome, stunted growth, facial deformity, sudden infant death syndrome, miscarriage.
Alcohol-related violence, child abuse, 50% of cases, violence toward loved ones, 30% of cases, violent acts, 40 to 80% of cases, suicides, 20 to 50% of cases, plus more.
For help quitting, please visit For more urgent information, please visit suprememastertv.com/killers.
For this year, I did not have the heart to celebrate Christmas. While knowing again and again that billions of innocent animals of all kinds, from the sea to the forest, are massacred for this occasion. Jesus was a compassionate master, the Son of God, and we who follow Jesus should be the same. Also, there's so many turmoil in the world, just wouldn't help my heart to feel happy in any way. I was At Christmas time, I was in a mountain, very deep in the mountain. There was no water, no electricity there, and I meditated day and night. And before Christmas also, and after Christmas. It's just because at New Year, and I thought, okay, I go down to the city where there is a little facility to contact you, talk to you, maybe for the last time. I don't mean last time, but like when we're together like this. And also that I could talk to the whole world like this, maybe for the last time. And then we have to go into deep meditation, yes? We have talked enough, I mean, everyone are grown up and understood things. We don't have to talk a lot in order for people to understand. You see, it is a practice of the knowledge. It's not the talking much. Because anyone who has a caring heart would understand my message, even spoken ones. Because I cannot also bear all this suffering course to humans and animals alike. You know very well.
Yes, Master.
So, and by the way, for the Supreme Master television staff around the world and in the headquarter there, I thank you all. It has been a privilege to be working with you all these years. And together, maybe we have caused a little good change in the world. Too little for us to celebrate anything. But for whatever little change we cause in the world, I thank heaven and all of your good effort. May God bless you forevermore.
Thank you, Master.
Also, thank you forever. I also congratulate those who have realized that life is not just about getting a diploma, getting a job, or getting married, be getting children, and then die. So, though this is what our system seems to emphasize and encourage everybody, but life does not start here, when we are born, or end when we are dead. And enlightenment is only the beginning. Congratulations also to those brave and wise beings who float above all shackles and temptations, designated to ensnare the pure souls into physical, emotional, and mental slavery, to so much sorrow and trouble that they forget their true great self, forgetting to soar higher into the higher spiritual dimension, forget to go back home to their great original abode. Again, I tell you, enlightenment is only the beginning. The journey will continue, full of wonder and miraculous encounter and discovery for those who truly want to know the miracle of life and the real love from the universe and from your heart. I take this opportunity to remind all fellow beings here and elsewhere in the universe to continue striving for noble ideas, lofty goal of peace and unconditional love. Even if you fail, please try again and again until you succeed. And succeed you will, sooner or later. The sooner the better. Because you will know things that you never thought you would know before. When you uplift yourself into a higher spiritual understanding, You thought you know already everything. Some might think like that. No. Even I don't know everything yet. I mean, how much our brain can accumulate and can digest, you see? Even if I know everything, I have to take out some that I need every day. I cannot sit here and say, now I know everything already. I cannot know everything at one go. You see, it's all in the store for us. We have to meditate deeply in order to realize the spiritual splendor and treasure that we have within ourselves, that lay dormant there, life after life, unused, or very little used. I wish all of you good luck with a new star for betterment in New Year. And I embrace you all with my love and best wishes. I will continue to meditate and pray for us all. Love, love.
Thank you, Master.
You're welcome. Is there anything else? Yeah, I'm listening.
Master, we just wanted to express our gratitude for this extraordinary journey and for this gift to the planet that you've given us and for this opportunity to work with you and to serve the world. Thank you for your love and patience and generosity and guidance through all the years.
On behalf of humankind, the animals, and all the beings on this planet, our deepest gratitude for your sacrifice, compassion, and wisdom. We sincerely pray that all of humankind will soon heed your words by choosing an animal-free diet and doing good deeds to save the planet.
From all of us here and with all viewers who are tuning into this live broadcast, Happy Vegan New Year, Supreme Master Ching Hai.
Happy Vegan New Year to you and to all. And I love you very much. With all my heart. I love all with all my heart.
Thank you so much, Master.
Thank you, Master.
I see you sometime, okay? I mean you. Association members. Oh, by the way, please, all of us, at least our association members, please be more diligent in your spiritual practice. Forsake or else accept the necessary duties to your families and the world. Save time for meditation, for a world vegan, world peace. I love you all. Disciples and non-disciples, animals, trees, rocks, planet. I love you all. Love so much.
Master.
Thank you, Master.
So long, huh?
Bye, Master.
Bye, Master.
Even if I don't see you again, you're all in my heart, okay? And in my meditation and in my prayers, okay? Love you.
We love you.
Love, love.
Bye, Master.
Bye.
Bye, Master.
Bye. As Supreme Master Television bade farewell on January 2nd, after more than 5 years of bringing constructive programs around the globe, staff members in Los Angeles, California, USA, were surprised and honored by the loving presence of Supreme Master Qinghai via video conference.
Thank you for sending
me. We're just forever grateful.
Just for all the support and love you gave.
Expressing the sadness she shared with cherished global viewers, whose kind messages of support began pouring in soon after the farewell announcement, Supreme Master Qinghai conveyed her warm appreciation for all friends and worldwide staff of Supreme Master Television. Supreme Master Qinghai also revealed new information about spiritual blessing portals at some of our association's meditation centers and other locations across the world, as well as how much blessing power each location has. We now invite you to this candid conference with Supreme Master Qinghai and Supreme Master Television staff in Los Angeles, California, USA, which took place on January 2, 2012.
Supreme Master Qinghai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Are you all right?
Yes, Master.
Feel happy or sad or relieved or reluctant?
Sad, Master.
Sad? Really?
Yes.
Yes, Master.
You're not happy that you don't have to work anymore?
For a little bit.
A little bit?
Maybe
a little
few
bit,
minutes,
yeah.
But then when we realized that the TV station went black, it was just a really sad feeling.
Yeah, same here. I think because the people are sad, that's why, you know.
Yeah.
Well, now everybody would feel very, you know, sudden sadness, yes. So it's also overwhelming for me, overwhelming my heart. Yeah. I just also feel very sad because suddenly the TV also went black, you know. Mm.
Yes, Master.
And then I have to run and find the assistant who's sleeping and wake him up and say, wake up. You know, I want to watch TV. Because the last night I want to watch the whole thing, you know, even again and again until it's all gone. But suddenly it's gone because it was an Astra.
Oh, yes.
So not the hot bird. And then later he come up and he tried very hard to put it back on hot bird, but it doesn't work also. I don't know why. And then so I came downstairs to the studio and I'm watching on the internet and feel a little comforted. I was also very sad. I truly was very sad.
Yes, Master.
Yeah. Yes. And I'm sure it is because of the whole world also feel sad. You know, it's really overwhelming. I have never feel so sad not to watch TV before, any TV at all.
Yes, Master.
But I guess our TV is different, you know?
Yes, Master.
I mean, this TV is really top. I mean, for my own very picky standard, I think it's a top one. You know, quality and heartfelt and, you know, really, truly unconditional love that we offer to the world, and we do our best. And, you know, I have always following up to make sure quality is tip-top, né? Yeah. I still have your images in my mind, so we don't have to see you today, maybe some other time, you know, but today is too sad. I don't feel like changing clothes and making up and combing hair. I just run in pyjama going down here and talk to you.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you,
so
Master.
Much.
Thank you for
we
your love,
so
Master.
We feel so blessed.
It's okay. I guess you must feel very sad. I mean, at least some of you feel sad. All of you feel sad?
Yes,
we
Master.
All feel sad,
we all
Master.
Feel sad.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, well, I'm so sorry. Well, if you have time, I would let you come see me, but if you want, you can come see me for a while. A Okay. That really sells, huh? Sells like hotcakes, huh? Okay. Okay. I don't know if maybe you guys still busy, right? You must catching up or tidy up or anything. So what do you guys want to do now? For example.
They said they want to see you, Master.
Oh, my God. Okay. Couldn't you take a joke? Okay. Yes, we will think about that. The thing is, there's good and bad things. If you guys come and stay a while, maybe you don't want to go anymore.
Exactly.
Then I would like to, but would you stay and meditate a lot or not?
Yes, Master.
Anything you want, Master.
Because there's not much to do, just to meditate now, okay?
That's the thing. Yes, Master.
Yeah. Master.
Yeah, it's good. But sometimes when you stay around long and then you get bored and then you think other kind of thing and you bug me inside, and that's also the problem. Yeah, I tell you something. Yeah, tell me. Choco, what?
Yeah, I was going to say we'll try our best, Master.
Yeah, everybody say that, baby. I heard that for years, decades of experience. Now, I tell you something. I really love to see you guys and love to have you. You know that. It's sincerely
yes,
like
Master.
That.
Mm.
Just sometimes we have side effect, you know? Yeah, that I probably could not meditate too well because you guys are around and you think of something else. Because many people have different things, you know? They all have different kind of mentality and expectation and stuff. Yeah, originally I wanted to go back to the mountain where you won't last because there's no electricity, no water. Over there, definitely you have to sit and be breatharian, I think. A very simple life. It's a very small place. Anyway, I'm afraid you're uncomfortable. You know there's no bed. You can just sit all day.
We don't mind, Master.
We don't mind, Master.
Okay, love. All right, thank you. I'm very touched by your love. But I was trying to tell you, how long can I talk? Is it okay?
Forever.
yeah, now we have no work now, right?
Right.
Only the world makes us busy, otherwise we have nothing to do, eat and sleep and sing song. Okay, I'll tell you something. When I was in a mountain, you know, where there's no electricity, no water, yeah? I mean,
yes,
really
master.
Like that, huh?
Yes,
I'm not joking, huh? Hmm?
Yes, Master.
Okay?
Yes,
I'm
yes.
not joking. And then it's very quiet inside and outside. And I went down to the city to want to contact you guys for the last time. I thought, you know, we say goodbye to everybody, yeah?
Yes, Master. Yes.
Anyway, I came down here and there were about 13 people in this house, working, repairing house and stuff, you know, trying to connect the internet for me. And beginnings, so different things. Normally, when I was in the mountain, I could meditate a lot more. And if I'm tired, I sleep very well. And I eat only once a day, if I do eat even, you know?
Yes, Master.
Mm. And I don't feel like hungry. Yes. Yeah, I didn't feel hungry or nothing. Just eat because I'm bored sometimes, nothing else to do. Yeah. Also in the mountain, you cannot eat a lot. There's no water there. You just have a little bit of rain water and you have to recycle everything, you know? And I did not feel hungry and, you know, nothing. I just ate sometime because I'm bored. Truly like that. And now, after I came down here to the city, you know, it's not really in the center of city even. It's just that I have 13 people here. And they're all different. I can see that very well. The way they behave, the way they talk. Even just the way they look at me, I know who is who. But I don't mind. It's just that, I feel like I became a different person. You know?
Yes, Master.
I feel like I wanted to eat all day.
Wow.
And then at night, I can't even sleep. I stay watching TV all night. I can't even meditate very well. I can't sleep. I can't meditate very well. I eat a lot. I feel so shameful, but I like a different, completely different person all of a sudden. And I talk to myself. I say, what now? What's going on? What's going on with you? What happened? What happened to you? You better behave. Stop it. Stop it. But then it seems like, you know, when they eat, I come out and eat with them, just like that. Not even thinking, you know, not even feeling hungry. Just go eat. And another thing is, I really enjoy the food here even. I can't believe it. You know, like those silly bread, sliced bread, yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
White, you know, that I always look down upon. And I don't even... I don't even in my dream think about eating these things. Here, it tastes so good even. I cannot believe it. Oh my God. For example, those things that I always look down upon, that I don't even want to look. I never touch them. I never eat them. Oh God, here, it tastes like I have never eaten for many days. I don't know what to do. I just keep eating. Okay. Shamelessly. Well, shamefully, but eat. Yeah. Anyway, so only 13 people. And it's like that, okay? I don't know what happened when all of you come. Especially, you are used to more with good food over there, you know? In the mountain, for example, I can't even cook. I don't even cook, you know? I just eat like whatever is there, you know?
Yes, master.
Like cold tofu and very hard bread, rock hard bread. Because we can't just keep going shopping every day. So buy once for like 10 days or 2 weeks. So the bread become like a rock. I'm not exaggerating. So I have to bang it on. I really bang it very hard on the table. And then it breaks, but then it fell all over on the floor. Something like that. But the dogs love it. When it breaks and fell on the floor, that's their that's their fortune. Because my dogs, they love French bread, you know?
Yes, master.
And French bread, it goes hard very fast. They become like rock, yeah? Rock, yes, really master. Rock. But it will like the bone, you know? And then the dogs love it. And like the Nyla bone, you know, hard, but not hard. Not hard enough for them, but hard. So they chew it, crack, crack, crack. Oh, they enjoy it. Oh, my God. And because of that, I discover for the first time that even hard bread can eat for human. You know, there's one good thing about today. One good thing, after the TV went black, I was very sad. And then I said to myself, oh, don't be so silly. At least there's very good thing. Now I don't ever have to watch like vegetarianism, the noble way of living anymore. Yeah. Because just watching them and then go and eat those hard bread. And cold moly tofu and hard bread, rock hard bread like that. You know, it doesn't seem to be a very kind thing to do for myself. But since a long time, it's like that. You know, not just a mountain there. When I was in the other place also, I live like in a mobile home. Not a mobile home, like a trailer, you know?
Yes, master.
You know, the one with 4 wheels or 6 wheels? And
yes. Yes.
They hook it on the car and...
Yes, trailer.
They hook it on the car and took it somewhere. Yeah?
Yes, master.
Okay. Sometimes I had to just anywhere. And recently, it's all like that. And squeezing together with dogs and even teleconference with the whole world with that in that kind of squeezy room, you know, very small, like 2x3, something like that. And I even have internet, so can, you know, the first thing to do is have internet so we can connect. That was it. And so recently it's always like that, very long time already, just, you know, cold bread or whatever, and then cold tofu, you know, and whatever, and then just a little soy sauce or Maggi, you know, and then just like that. And I discover also it's okay too. Because if you have to cook, then you have to wash a lot. So if you don't cook, then you don't need to wash anything. Yeah. And nowadays, when we don't watch the beautiful, fantastic cooking shows on the Supreme Master television anymore, then everything doesn't seem so bad. You don't compare anymore. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like sitting, watching all these delicious, mouth-watering things on the TV and all colorful, and they even taste it on TV for you to look at. They tell each other, okay, now you can taste, and the other taste and say, oh, yum, yum, my God. And then when you go into your cupboard and drag out the hard rock bread, then you don't feel like your day is a very good day. So today I said to myself, don't be silly. At least I don't have to watch the mouth watering, all the cooking shows on the Supreme Master TV anymore. And then go and eat the cold bread. So it's one good thing. Yeah, that's the only good thing. And the rest is no good. I'm sure people will miss our TV a lot.
Yes, Master.
And you know what? I really still think our TV is top, not because it's our TV, but because it is. You know I'm picky, right? Yes. You know I'm very picky. Very picky and very detailed and perfectionist, no?
Yes, Master.
I mean, not all the things that we do on TV are to my liking. Even, I mean, not 100% perfect, but still, it's a top TV, yeah?
Yes, Master.
I have to say, and then I'm proud that you guys did good job. All of the staff around the world, not just you guys, but you know, all the writers and researchers and, you know, info collectors. Oh, you top notch, because you find out information so fast and so accurate. I would not be able to do that alone. I would not be able to sit down and find out all this information myself. You see what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Yeah, you know how good I am with the computer. I could not even turn it on. I don't even know how. Yeah, one or twice I have been able to turn it on, but that's just about it, you know? If they set up everything, then maybe I can turn it on, that's all. But then when if something goes wrong, that's it. I have to keep yelling at them, come back, come back. What happened? What happened? Look at that. Now is the TV on the Supreme Master television, internet, and they're cooking again. Oh. All this exquisite, you know, top-notch chef in the world even. Even our disciples, our association members, they cook also so well. At least it look on TV, you know, compared to the hard rock bread. My God. I don't know how it tastes, but it looks so good. And they even try and they say, my God, delicious, yum, yum, yum. And then I say to myself, oh, yeah, yeah, I have some yum, yum bread here. 2 weeks old. Yeah. Or cold rice. Sometimes they cook something for the dogs and they give me some rice. And sometimes I don't eat and I keep it for 3-4 days and it's so cold and so hard, like, not cooked rice, you know, like uncooked or half-cooked. Yeah, and then after you watch all this yum-yum, you go eat that rice. Oh, my God. Oh, what a fortune. But, you know, you get used to it, you know. I'm just telling you, in case you want to come to see me and then there's nothing there for you, like where you live.
We don't mind. We don't mind.
We don't mind.
Now you say that, but I'm not sure. Even I do mind after I watch all this. After all, I watch all this beautiful, colorful, tasty and yummy food and then I go eat that cold rice after 3, 4, 5 days of rice. Oh, it don't taste like heaven at all. But you get used to it, you know. I mean, I got used to it. I really am more for a spiritual side. That's why I bear anything. Yeah,
yes,
I don't
Master.
Care. I don't care. I really don't care. And if I don't have food, I also don't care. Because I, wherever I go, it is because of practice. Yeah?
Yes, Master.
Oh, so that I can meditate for the world. Yeah? And the rest is secondary. And even that, I was very grateful. I'm just making joke with you, you know, the mind complain a little bit now and then, but I make him eat it. I make myself eat it. No problem. And then you get used to it. And I was always grateful even then, you know?
Yes, Master.
For such a tranquil place and a safety, and that even have some rainwater to use, even recycle water, but have some water. Some people don't even have water, you know what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Yeah. So I was always very grateful and very happy, indeed. But I'm not sure if I could put you through all that, because if you are here, probably I will not go to the mountain and probably will have to stay in the city, near the city, not in the city. Near the city and, you know, it's easier to shop, you know, and to cook and stuff. Yeah, it won't be any problem. Actually, it's also good like that. I myself was very grateful, have been very grateful, and still am very grateful, considering the state of the world today. And people don't even have cold rice to eat, no?
Yes, Master.
They don't even have container to even try to catch the rain.
Yes, Master.
And they don't have a roof over their head, even though my roof is just like a plastic. There is an old house there, but I prefer to go to... I have a little house, my own temple. I call it the temple. It's a plastic, you know what I mean?
Yes, Master.
You buy those storeroom, 1 meter 90, 1 meter 47. You know those storeroom that they sell ready-made plastic?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, it's more sturdy than a tent. And the water come from the roof, you can catch it with a container, you know?
Yes, Master.
Buy some container and let the water run in there, and then you can use, just like that. But it doesn't rain a lot all the time. Yeah, it takes like long time to fill up and then use it so fast. So over there, water is like gold. We have to recycle, yeah. But I was always happy, I tell you truly. I was very grateful because a good place to meditate, understand? That's important.
Yes, Master.
That's the only thing that is important, yes. So I told you already the pro and con of stuff. But no matter where I am, I'm always grateful, as long as I could meditate. You know, as long as there's a good place to meditate. There's some place better than other place to meditate. Do you understand?
Yes, Master.
For example, there are some place that is also very blessed, huh? More blessed than other place. It's just that there are neighbors around and they're smoking and they cook fish and all that, and the wind doesn't discriminate where it blows. Yeah. Especially if you stay in like a trailer, huh? Then the next door is only like a meter or so away, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, and so everything they hear, they share it with you, you know? TV, radio. Mm. And everything they smoke, they also very generously share it with you. Yeah, sometimes they smoke cigars, even worse, and pipe or whatever. And then when they cook the fish and the shrimp and all that, oh my God, they give you a headache. Truly like that, yeah? So there are good places and not, and better places and best places, you know, in the world, okay?
Yes, Master.
Whenever I can find a good place to meditate, I'm always very grateful. But I'm not sure if you guys can feel the gratefulness for such things, or you're just curious and just want to come spur of the moment, and later you say, oh, I want to go back to my girlfriend, my sister, stuff,
no,
and
Master.
Even...
No,
fine.
I sincerely want to come.
Yeah, I understand that. But the thing is, sometimes, right now I have still some people here, still working, finishing the job. But later on, maybe they're all gone, only one left. Maybe I have to bring another one or two here. Because I have dogs and need to work something with computer stuff, clean the house. Or maybe I go back to the mountain. Not sure what to do yet. Anyway, what I mean is, okay, it's fine that you want to go back to your girlfriend or boyfriend. I understand everything. Because each one is a different level. We cannot force a little baby to run, eh? Yeah?
Yes, Master.
But it's just very nice if anyone can cut all ties with the world and just feel so free. Yeah? That's a very nice feeling.
Yes, Master.
And sometimes you don't get that nice feeling until you are very old. Even then, maybe not. Okay? So I understand anything, everything, but it's just that then it might be like we are not in the same boat. We're not in the same direction. Yeah. And then if you come around, maybe you disturb yourself. The thing is, you want to go back to your girlfriend or boyfriend, but you won't even tell me that. You understand me? That's the worst thing. And then you keep bottling it up inside, and I'm more and more sensitive now. See what I mean?
Yes, Master.
Now I can see through things more than before. Before I was more busy and more couldn't care less. But the thing is, the more you meditate, the more you're sensitive to everything. And if you can see people past life and all that, it's even worse. Because sometimes the people around are not always our friends in the past life. They have not been friends. And in this life, even though they already turn around and wanted to be good, but still the past karma still linger around and then bugging people, making trouble or that, especially if they are on a lower level. And it's very difficult to even tell them because they will not understand. Yeah, because number one is the level different. Their idea, their conception is very different. Understand?
Yes, Master.
Do you know what I mean? When sometimes you talk to somebody, you yourself, and then you feel, my God, he or she is too far away.
Yes, Master.
You know, they talk the same language, but you don't understand each other. And it seems that guy is even just talking, he's too far, you know, still too far from anywhere. You guys have water or anything there?
We're fine, Master.
Okay. So we will think about these things, huh? Maybe. Whew. Yeah, but if you just come and see for a while, maybe no problem, eh? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
I don't know where to put you.
We can squeeze.
Oh, no. You can only squeeze when there are spaces to squeeze. When there's no space, where you squeeze? You understand?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, I'm sure we can arrange something. It's just that there will be no inches left unturned, no stone unturned. We don't even have big garden or anything here. And this is already a very big place compared to the mountain, compared to the N-E-W. You know what that is?
No, Master.
N-E-W?
New.
It doesn't mean new, no. It means no electricity, water. That place, even if you want to squeeze, you can't. You can't even get in. How you squeeze anywhere? There's no room. Just like a working room for the farmers in a long time ago, you know what I mean?
Yes.
Like where they store their instruments to work?
Yes.
Yeah. Because it's far away from their homes, or they put everything there, and when they come there, they work, you know? Yeah, that's it. I cannot see them? Can I see them or not? Yeah. Only if they are ready for that. Is it ready?
Yes, Master.
We're good.
You have camera there, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Okay, you don't mind if you don't see me?
It's okay, Master.
Now I can see all these beautiful people in suits and all that. My God.
Hi, Master.
Hi. Hey, yeah. You still look beautiful.
Thank you, Master.
You saw me yesterday anyway, right? It's no problem.
We still want to see you, Master.
You saw me all day on TV, no?
It's not enough, Master.
It's the same.
We want to see you, Master.
Yeah, yeah, you grown up already, okay?
Please, Master, please.
You talk like babies. you don't try to make me love you so much like my dogs. I know all these tricks. Yeah, they also make me love them so much, and then I could not go anywhere without them. Mm. And then they grow on you, you know? You just love them more and more every day. Mm. Well, this is a problem. But many of my dogs die already, you know.
Sad.
Oh. They just went to heaven. But don't worry, they all went to fifth heaven. Low fifth. But even then, I miss them so much.
Yes,
whenever I see them on TV, you know, when you show the picture and all that. Yeah, I miss them so much. I still cry sometimes. I miss their nearness, you understand? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
You can see somebody in heaven now and then when you're not busy is different than when you see them every day. Yeah?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, and the physical body, physical nearness is also very comfortable. You can hug them, you can talk to them, yeah? And they can come around and sissy-sassy with you and... it's completely different. Mm. Oh, you're using all my photograph, eh? I mean the photo that I took. They are just the countryside stuff. I saw you now on TV, you know, for the last time we spoke, and you're all beautiful. And me too, more beautiful. Oh, I am not made of nothing, no wearing dress, nothing, no makeup. Okay, where were we? You want to tell me something? You tell me, huh? Don't make me telling all the time.
Master, we'd like to share some feedback from some of the viewership.
Yeah, tell me.
Okay, the first one is from a video journalist in Canada. Her name is Anita Kraschik.
Okay, tell me the story.
Yes, Master. She says, thank you for the past 5 years of truthful vegan animal rights.
Oh, she just wrote right now?
Yeah.
These are just from...
Because she knows that we goodbye, yeah?
Yes, right, Master.
Right, Master. Oh, very touching. Still write to us. Thank you. Tell me.
Okay, I'll read it. Thank you for the past 5 years of truthful vegan animal rights and climate protection programming.
Yeah.
Please let us know if we can do anything to support a relaunch of this much-needed and much-loved vegan global channel. Thank you for the world, Master. Thank you for the gift for this world.
It's all right. I live here also, baby. Come on. What else you say?
I believe a lot of people would support it like they do public broadcasting stations.
Ah.
I can't think of a station that deserves more support. We don't have a lot of examples of media that speaks truth to power again and again.
Right.
Thank you, and I hope it is possible to relaunch soon. Love, love, love.
Okay. Oh, that's nice. That's nice.
There's a little bit more. On her own account, she also wrote, "This news makes me very sad. Supreme Master TV covered our recent fundraising event with Counselor Glenn the Burmaker, and their TV crew were a joy to work with.
Mm-hmm.
I regularly watch their awesome animal rights and environmental programming whenever I go to Loving Hut. This global vegan channel will be sorely missed."
Yeah, I think so. Even I miss it, you know, and I normally don't miss anything. Okay.
There's a lot more. Could we share some
more? She wrote more?
Oh, no, a lot of other viewers.
Okay. Yeah, after. Could you please write to all of them and tell them that I also thank them personally and you thank them also, okay?
Yes, Master.
Just reply them at least some lines afterward, okay? After you receive, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Say, my heartfelt gratitude and my purest love for them, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Okay, please read more.
Okay, Dr. Will Tuttle wrote, Wow, many thanks for the 5 fabulous years. What an enormous blessing to our earth, Supreme Master TV has been. So sorry to see it ending, but the love of the Supreme Master Qinghai community for animals and people and the earth is, it seems to me, never ending. I'm in awe of Supreme Master TV and the Supreme Master Qinghai community and the Loving Huts also. Deepest thanks.
Yeah, we still continue to do, you know, charity work whenever we can, eh?
Yes, Master.
It's just that we don't have Supreme Master TV anymore, yeah?
Yes, Master.
It's also a good thing. Sometimes we talk too much. This doesn't mean people listen, okay?
Yes, Master.
It's like when your parents keep telling you all the good things, you say, oh yeah, you know. Yeah. Or when you married after 3 years, you know, your husband says something, your wife says something, you say, oh yeah. yeah, and then you do the 99, you know? You say yes to anything. And then you do all the no to everything, a thing like that. You know, the same with the relationship everywhere, huh? Maybe also good like that. And 5 years, I think it was enough already, huh? Mm. Also, we work very hard, and I think we also need to meditate, huh?
Yes, Master.
I think because of Supreme Master TV, a lot of people don't meditate enough, no? What do you say? Yes or no?
Yes, Master.
Yeah. They sacrifice a lot, eh? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
Many of them are still at home and they have to work or take care of the family and they have to do translation or do research and for us and everything. I'm ever grateful. Hmm?
Yes, Master.
Yeah, I really mean it. You know, I really meant it when I say I'm grateful. I did not say that just to make you feel happy. I know how hard you work, all of you. I mean, the one in LA and the one around the world. You know, work very hard. Yeah, so there are many reasons that we should stop. Eh? First of all, heaven say stop. Yeah?
Yes, Master.
Maybe in the future, if humans behave better or if they're sincere, then maybe we can have the means to do it again. Who knows? But right now,
wow.
Yes? Sorry, what?
I'm just wowed.
Well, I don't know. I am saying maybe. You know what maybe means, right? They compare between a woman and a diplomat. Say when the diplomat say yes, he means maybe. When he say maybe, he means no. And if he ever say no, then he's not a good diplomat. And a woman, you know, right? You know. You can guess now. When she say no, she means maybe. When she say maybe, she means yes. And when she say yes, then she's not a good woman.
Master, you said maybe means yes, right?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that, yes. I'm also a diplomat, you see, because I have to please everybody, so I play both roles. I don't know if I'm still a woman or not, or whatever. Anyway, where were we?
You said heaven said no? Heaven said to stop?
Yeah, to stop. Because, yeah? Okay. And also for all the staff to rest, no? To meditate, no? Because meditate also very good for the world. No? We have been reminding them, and now they have to do it also. There are also a certain extent how much we can do, okay?
Yes, Master.
Like you can only chew food for your babies until he's 5 or something, maximum. Yeah, and then he has to eat. Got it?
Yes, Master.
Himself. All right. Otherwise, it's weird, and it's bad for him. They keep chewing food for him all the time.
Yes, Master.
Anyway, that was money well spent. I never regret You know, we could even continue if I wanted to, if heaven okay with it. You want to change? Okay, change it. Just 1 second. You can drink water or something meanwhile. Has to change the tape, in case we want to keep this tape, precious tape. Who knows? Who knows? It's become a historical event.
We all talk in pajama. Yeah, sometimes people have a pajama party, you know. We are joining the club now. It'll be some, it's me, I'm the thing. It's okay. I'm perfect inside.
I can tell you that now.
Mm? Yeah.
Well, I could be more perfect, but this is a perfect perfect, okay?
Yes, Master.
I could be more. Every day I check how much... Every day I check my purity as well, okay? Purity is also a very important quality. Remember in the Bible, it says, except you become a child, you cannot enter the kingdom of God?
Yes, Master.
That means purity. Purity is the state where you don't desire anything. You're not into this world for anything, you know, for gain, anything at all. Not even tiny, weeny, little bit. But this is for purity for the world and some worlds beyond. But you could continue further. Maybe until, let me see how much, like 2,700% pure. Wow. I'm now like maybe, I forgot how much was it upstairs. I forgot. Maybe 1,700 something.
Wow.
Oh, it's not 2,700 yet. but it's pure enough for this world.
Yes, Master.
The other more purity is because you have to shred more of the contamination out, shed it out, that's all. Yes, yes. But otherwise, that is pure already, you understand?
Yes, Master.
Most people in this world, they're only pure the maximum about 90%.
Oh.
Yeah, because too much contamination and not enough time to clean, you know, to meditate. And
yes, Master.
Yeah, like that. The higher you go into the kingdom of spiritual abode, the purer you become also, yeah? Also sometimes not too much contact with the world also help. You see, that's why all the Himalaya yogi, they don't want to go down. Because when they go down, they feel different. I told you already, just 13 people around and I eat all day. That slow down my purity progress also. Yeah, in the mountain, I go quick, you know?
Mm. Yeah.
And here, it's slow. It's okay. Nothing can touch me anymore, even though I'm not 2,700 yet. What I mean is, in this world, you can get up to that level, you know, of 2,700% of purity, but you don't have to. Like 200-300% is quite good already, yeah? I'm quite happy with myself, so I can afford to slow down a little bit. Doesn't matter, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Because every day I check myself how much zillion I earn today, how much purity I have, or lower down, or do I stop, or do I get up more? Every day I check now. Also, I check my health, you know, how healthy I am now compared to before. Oh, my God, what a difference when you could walk freely and could move your arm without pain, and when you lay down without screaming, ah, what a difference. Oh my God, I feel like a real person again.
Wow.
Yeah. Thank you. But it takes really long time to recover. And so the blood also have to recover because so much antibiotic and, you know, anesthesia and all kind of things they put into my body. And it takes so long to recover. But I'm almost okay now. I mean, I'm okay now. It's just that you can get to like 300% of the health status, yeah? And then you're invincible. Completely invincible. I'm now half invincible. Yeah. Well, not really half, a lot more than half, eh? When you're 100% pure, your blood, you're already very good, yeah? Well, it could be purer, you know, more celestial-like. You understand me?
Yes, Master.
Okay. Otherwise, health-wise, blood 100% pure is okay. It's okay already. I'm more than 100% pure now, the blood. Yeah. Not just health, not just purity in the spirit, but also the blood. That's why I tell you, you have to meditate more. You get more things, you know. You don't just see a few visions and hear some music, and then every day you understand this and that, and you think you know everything. A lot of people think like that, even my own disciples. I talk to them and I feel, my God, what an ego talking. It's the ego that talks. It says, don't know anything, don't understand anything. Just because maybe before he or she was a teacher of some kind, or martial arts, guru or something, and then everybody called them master and all that, and they feel like too big already. Do you understand me?
Yes, Master.
And then they read a lot of some of the Buddhist sutra, especially the Diamond Sutra, which is so famous, everybody had to read it. If not, then you're not a Buddhist, for example. And if you know a Diamond Sutra, then you are somebody, my goodness. For example, like that, and then just cling to that, and then just stop right there. Enlightenment, even, is only a beginning, I told you already. It is truly like that. But even before I know that, I still need to continue to be in the world and to let it be, to let myself be contaminated. Just like you have to jump in the water to rescue a drowning person. You understand me? Yeah?
Yes, Master.
Even you know, you might get sick, you might get wet, you might drown, you might even die. But if you want to do that, you do that, okay? Like that. And now if you don't have to rescue people, then you have to recuperate yourself, yeah? Clean up yourself and take care of your lung and your hypothermal state, yeah? Have to recover, yeah, thing like that. And then you have to be healthy again, yeah? For example, and then you have to retrain yourself to be stronger, yeah? In case you have to rescue people again. But sometimes people don't want to be rescued, then you just let them. Why not? Sometimes like insects come into my house. I told them all already, don't come inside the wall because you might get crushed, you might get sick in here with all kind of things, or the dog might step on you or scare you and you have heart attack, everything. But sometimes they come in. Okay, and then I try to get them out, but sometimes they don't want. They say, they'd rather die in my house. So I say, okay, you're welcome. Yeah, what to do? I cannot chase him all night, you know, like a moth or something, yeah, or a small insect, but they can fly. I cannot. They fly all over, and I cannot chase forever. And I say, what now? You don't want to go out? You want to die in here? I say, yeah. So that's that. Well, it's his right, you know?
Yeah.
So that's that, huh? Okay, that's the way it is. Sometimes I go to like somewhere near the river or on the beach, and I saw people staying there and do the fishing. And it's really heartbreaking to see it. So I tell all the fish, get away, get 10 kilometers away from the shore, don't go near. And if you see anything, you know, moving, you know, strangely in the water, just don't go eat it. But if you want to die, then just do that. So I tell them, yeah, what to do, you know? You have to let them also have a choice, yeah? Even bad choice, but I tell them if you go near the shore and if you go near where the human with the sticks, then you will die. Don't eat anything. At the end of that stick, don't go that near stick, just 10 kilometers away. And when you see the boat or hear the boat, you go far, far away as possible if you want to live. But in case you want to die, then that's where you will. Sometimes they listen, sometimes they don't, eh? Sometimes that times it up, you know?
Yes, Master.
It's heartbreaking, but I learned to live with it. But sometimes I see things on TV, oh, terrible, I still cannot bear. I keep telling the Maya of this world that this world is hell. Whatever he created is no good. Everything he does is no good here. For everybody, for the animals, for the humans, all these temptations and traps and tricks, you know, make people lose their purpose and cannot even defend for themselves too. And then everybody contaminate everybody else. Do you understand?
Yes.
It's really a pitiful state of being to live in this world. animals or men. It's terrible. Okay. So, I forgot. You have more letter, right?
Yes, Master.
You can read to me. I know they're very sad. I'm sure they're very sad. That is really sincere, you know. They're not playing it.
Yes, Master.
They had no reason to, yeah. Even I was so sad when suddenly the TV go black, you know. I try to get it back, I cannot, and I feel like I lost something.
Yeah.
Like I feel like I could not even say goodbye yet. You know, I mean, I'm not ready, thing like that. So I run down the stair and ask the assistant to wake up and, you know, try to fix the TV. I thought maybe it's the TV, but it's not. And then so I say, okay, well, maybe check out if we can have it on internet, you know. And after I watch a little bit on internet, I feel a little better. But I know it's just a few more hours. Yes. Anyway, I'm talking to you. I thought maybe you must feel very sad. So I said, never mind. We contact them, see. Just talk to them, comfort them a little bit.
Oh, thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
Just in case you need it. And you did need it, right?
Yes, Master.
Also feel better for me, too, talking to you. Yeah, it's also for me, huh? Not just for you. Okay, you read to me, or if you have any question or anything, you're free to ask anything today, okay? Or tell me anything.
Thank you, Master.
Mm. Not just you, Choco, I mean all of them.
Yes, I understand.
I don't know, because you always say, yes, Master, and nobody else says anything.
I have a microphone, Master.
I know. Isn't that not fair? Tell me, Choco.
This is from Haley Marie Norman, vegan actress. She was in one of the hosts for TRL.
Uh-huh.
She says, I can't believe the TV station is closing. So sad.
Yeah.
That's her message.
People on Facebook wrote messages about how sad they were. Yeah, in just a matter of hours.
Oh my God, okay. So whoever receive it, please reply, okay? Tell them to reply, whoever, yeah? And send it to them, okay?
Yes,
multimedia,
Master.
Multimedia, at least something for them, okay? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
Right, tell me. More? Any more?
Yes. Northern Aurora X Jeffrey Khan on Twitter said, I feel a great sense of loss that Supreme Master TV and Supreme Master Qinghai will no longer be broadcasting. There's like a sad face. Best wishes to the team, Supreme Master TV, and Supreme Master Qinghai will always have a place in my heart. Supreme Master TV is a network that helped me push my diet towards a compassionate meat-free diet, which is still evolving. However, I'm happy to know that Supreme Master TV archived programs will remain online and free of charge.
What does that mean? Just our old program, right?
Yeah, the old programs.
Okay, okay.
The archived programs.
Yeah, okay. They can watch again and all that. Okay, good.
Yes, Master.
Yeah, all right. Just you reply all to them, okay? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
Just say thank them and comfort them and say we really deeply appreciate your love and your affection, yeah? But it's just time to say goodbye, yeah? We will be meditating with them in our heart. Yeah, any more love?
Yes, Master. This is from Kayandian Idananta.
My God, how did you get it so fast? How did you know I'm going to talk to you that you collect it so fast?
They were on Twitter and...
You printed out.
Twitter, a lot of them Facebook, are emails and...
Yeah.
And, yeah, online.
Oh, that's so fast. Okay, tell me.
Yeah, she says, I love you, Master. I love you, Supreme Master TV. Sad face with tears 3 times.
Oh, terrible. It's all heartbreaking now. Only now I realize that they will be sad. You know, before I don't realize it. I thought, okay, we just say goodbye. I thought they might be sad, but now I really realize that they really are sad.
Yes, Master.
Not because you read this letter, but because it's really happening, you know? Before we only know it, but we didn't really know it. You know, now it's really happening. It really hit us and it hit everybody. It's a different when it really happened than when you imagine, okay?
Yes, Master.
Okay, continue, please.
Adialian Inea Shu wrote, no, Supreme Master TV is over. I'm so sad.
Oh.
Exclamation point. Exclamation marks.
Yeah.
Yeah. The next one is from Katie Neal. She says, "Thank you, Master, and everyone at Supreme Master TV. We will miss Supreme Master TV so much. Sad face, kisses."
From Facebook, Arlene Fogarty wrote, "Supreme Master TV was pretty much my only connection with Supreme Master. I'm sad to see this stop. I know I've been changed in major ways. Thank you all for the programs. I long for connection. My friend is in Oregon. I am in Florida. I miss connection. Thank you all. Mickey Fogarty."
Okay.
Yes, another one from Facebook, from Nina Vecchi. "Thank you so much for all your wonderful programming and uplifting news that was broadcasted. It was an honor to have participated with the Supreme Master TV team, and something I will value forever. This will be sorely missed."
Yeah.
From Twitter, it's Royo, who asked about practicing the Kuan Yin method, wrote, "Will the website still be available? Master Qinghai is the truth. God bless."
Thank you.
And those are just a few that we were able to gather for right now.
For now.
Yes.
For now, huh?
Yes, Master.
Some more that you did not get?
I think many more.
Surely we can get some more.
But this is all we were able to compile for now.
Okay, understand. It takes some time, right? To get it, right?
Yes, Master.
Okay, I think more or less is similar, hey?
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
Similarly sad, yes. I knew it because it suddenly hit me, because when it went blank and I could not retrieve it again, then it hit me, yeah? And then all the overwhelming sadness from the audience hit me all at once.
Wow.
Oh, I never felt so sad like that. So
wow.
Sad.
Wow.
So I had to call you, one of your sister, and ask, well, what happened? Is it already really finished now? And she say, our heart was still, because they respect us and like us so much, they let us broadcast until 9 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. But every other is already slowly or quickly finished. Yeah, actually, because it's already 3rd January already. It's not the 2nd anymore. So if it's finished, it's normal. Yeah?
Yes, Master.
They only say we can broadcast until 2nd of January anyway.
Yes, Master.
Only Hotbird let it go until tomorrow, until in the morning, a few more hours. Yes. But it really feels like lost something, you know, suddenly went blank like that. Yeah. I know.
It feels like...
Yes.
I'm sorry. It just feels like a beacon of light and hope just went out, and I think a lot of us felt really lost.
Oh. Yeah. It's good. Maybe it's good. So people will rethink about it, okay?
Yes, Master.
We did what we can.
Yes, Master.
I did what I can. You did what you can. But at least we make some example for all the media. I think many of the television channels copy our style a lot. I saw
yes,
some.
Yes, Master.
For example, you know, like I've seen some TV that normally they only use like their own people, and later they hire, you know, black people and white people. Yeah. And then some TV even say something in foreign languages, you know?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Just like us, we say hello in, you know, or sayonara, something like that. And then we say it's Japanese, and you know?
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
I remember after I go around some cities for the fashion show, and then after that, immediately I saw some of the designer, you know, the color all comes out. You know, similar.
Yes, Master.
Before, mostly just black and black and then black again, you know. And after we have a fashion show, and then, oh, I saw different style come out with all colors, yeah. And now many TV also have much more color than before.
Yes.
And also for environment now, some program beginning to peep out, you know. for environment, yeah?
Yes, Master.
For green and for what makes people have cancer and things like that, you know? And
yes, Master.
Some about environment. Almost all TV, they have at least something about environment now, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
At least it's good, it's good. So we just make some example, and if they follow or not, we cannot force people. Yeah? We cannot.
Yes, 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 Master.
If they can learn something good from us, then it's already something. Mm. But of course it's not enough. I want the world to be vegan yesterday and peace the day before yesterday.
Some of the benefits of a vegetarian diet: lowers blood pressure, lowers cholesterol levels, reduces type 2 diabetes, prevents stroke conditions, reverses atherosclerosis, reduces heart disease risk 50%, reduces heart surgery risk 80%, prevents many forms of cancer, stronger immune system, increases life expectancy up to 15 years, higher IQ, saves 70% of a total cost of $40 trillion for reducing global warming, uses 4.5 times less land to grow food, conserves up to 70% clean water, saves 80% of the cleared Amazonian rainforest from animal grazing. A solution for world hunger. Free up 3.4 billion hectares of land. Free up 760 million tons of grain every year, half the world's grain supply. Consumes one-third fossil fuels of those used for meat production. Reduces pollution from untreated animal waste. Maintains cleaner air. Saves 4.5 tons of emissions per U.S. household per year. Stop 80% of global warming. Plus more. Save your life. Be veg. Go green.
For more urgent information, please visit www.SupremeMasterTV.com/save-our-planet.
Yeah. Okay. Anybody want to say something, ask something, complain something, share
Master,
something?
You said that the media are changing. Like, for example, France, they will have a show about vegetarianism and how it's helping the planet. And you know, the link between vegetarianism and greenhouse gas emission and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Also, other, I think they do them. They do them now. Yeah?
Yes, yes.
Sometimes slowly and subtly, but I see they're leaning toward that direction. They just didn't want to make it too obvious that they're just testing the water.
Yeah. Yes, Master.
They are doing it, and I'm so happy. Yeah.
And they try also to make more constructive shows, more positive also emissions.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're surprised that they have a lot of audience for that.
A lot of what? Audience?
A lot of public, yeah, audience.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
A lot of people are watching, yeah.
Yeah, people will. Yeah, if they go in that direction, then they will become like our TV. Well, never can become like that. But they will attract more audience, you know?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Anything more? Somebody wants to speak behind them?
Yeah.
Give the phone. Okay.
Master, I have a question about meditation.
Mm-hmm.
Could HAPI be considered as an official center so that remaining SMTV staff can group meditate there?
Why not? If you like it?
Yes, Master.
Okay. LA also very good now, yeah?
Yes, Master.
Oh, let me see. Oh, I have something now that you talk about.
I check. I come back. Leave it. I come back soon. I need to go and get my
book. Okay, I have just been checking on different centers, and here are the comparisons. There are some centers have heaven portals now.
Wow!
Like SMC, you know,
wow.
San Martin Center have some now.
Wow!
Even in Japan. Wood cabin that I bought,
wow.
Also have. In some places I used to stay meditate before, now have. Even small, like Elan Center, Costa Rica,
center.
Wow.
Malaysia center, you know, in the mountain. LA center.
Wow.
New Jersey center.
New Jersey.
Maoli center. Tainan center in Taiwan. Yongdong center in Korea.
Wow.
Yangmingshan in Taiwan. And some of the private houses. And the big storeroom in France also.
Wow.
Okay. And San Jose Center have also, of course, it's the same. San Jose Center didn't change anything yet. Some are for me. Okay, on the scale of 100, it goes like this. Like Sihu in Taiwan, about 80%.
Wow.
Spiritual blessing power.
Some
of the private house you don't like. My private house in France, 78% now.
Wow.
And San Martin Center, 70%.
Wow.
The Japan wood cabin area, 83%.
Wow.
Yangmingshan in Taiwan, 78%.
Wow.
Yilan Center, small one in the high mountain before, in Yilan. Taiwan, 77%. Costa Rica center, you know, the one I bought.
Yes, Master.
In the rural area, 88%.
Wow.
Malaysia mountain, 60%. It depends on how much blessing portal is there, you know? Not just blessing line, and also Heaven Gate or Heaven Rose going through it, yes. LA Center now 68%. New Jersey 69%. Supreme Master Television. The happy where you want it, you know, the area that you meditate, 62%.
Wow.
Not too much compared to LA Center, 68, huh? New Jersey 69, huh? Okay, some center even less than you, like Lai Yi Center, have a spiritual blessing line, but not much more. Only 50%. In Panama City, I have a house I bought there also, 45%. San Jose in the mountain, California, 58%. For example, those things. Did I say the big storehouse in the north of France is 85%?
Yes, Master.
Okay. That's just about it. The rest are not for you. The rest are not. Now you know your area, okay?
Thank you, Master.
Yes,
whew. San Martin Center is very good now. I mean, not just the center, but the surrounding, okay? It's very important. Like you have a piece of land, like 2 square meters, but around them also surrounded with blessing line, and it's okay. You see what I mean? Yeah. Also affect your meditation progress. Hong Kong also, I forgot. Hong Kong Center also, 70%.
Wow.
Sometime I forgot. I bought so many places, I forgot where is where. Yeah. Okay. Any more question?
Yes, Master, I had a question. You once said that if we wanted to, we could stay at a center and just like ask Supreme Master TV.
Yes.
Is that still a possibility for some of us?
Sure, sure. Wherever there's center and where is a place, you can go and stay.
Okay, thank you, Master.
Just go there, be good.
Yes, Master.
Be good. Be the best, yeah? Okay?
Thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
Yeah.
Master?
Yeah?
Now that SMTV is over, could some of us here at SMTV continue your work putting your lectures, music and poetry on DVDs?
Mm-hmm. And then? To sell?
We would like to put your words of wisdom between master and disciples.
Yeah, do what you like. Yeah, sure. And if anybody wants it, you can sell.
Thank you, Master.
Why not? Yeah, they're very nice. Like music and poetry, it's nicer than when I just do it alone, you know, and you make it a background, like everything. So beautiful.
Yes.
Just copy them down the way you presented it on TV, and then people would like it. Some people would like to have it.
Yes.
And beautiful background, yeah, and beautiful presentation.
And Master reciting and singing. Thank you.
Oh, that's a small part.
Main part.
Yeah, not just mine, but everybody else, you know? Other people as well. Mm.
Yes, Master.
If people demand it, then you do it for them, okay?
Okay, Master.
With some little cost, or you ask me, or if anybody demand it, and tell them on internet that there's available. If you request something, it will be available. Hmm? Something like that.
Yes, Master.
Okay.
Thank you, Master.
But I think they can download already, right? But if you put it...
Yes, Master.
If you put on TV, it's better quality, right?
Yes, Master.
Okay,
Master.
Okay. Well, if there's a demand, then you supply. Okay? Yeah.
Thank you, Master.
Mm. Save more time also for meditation. Yeah. Yeah, Debbie?
Hi, Master. I heard that there's been requests for music. They want to download the music from the Real Love, and yeah. Also some of our other anniversary songs.
Yeah.
Is that okay also?
You didn't let them download? I thought they did. No?
I'm not sure of the process or if they... I'm not sure how it works.
Yeah, whatever. Whatever. Okay?
Okay.
And if not, then you make DVD and then tell them they can buy. Huh?
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Master.
Maybe make DVD for them because I don't know. Whatever you do. Okay? Whatever.
Okay. Thank you, Master.
You're welcome. They even want to go around with the show around the world. If they go around like that, it would cost a lot of money, huh? Like Michael Jackson style, right? Bring the whole group and everything. Wow, that would be a big responsibility. It's too much work, huh? Yeah. I don't think we are equipped for that. There's so many things we could do. We need to meditate more, eh? Okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Otherwise, we become like film producer or film script writer, director, and all kind of thing. Then we'll be busy, no end. I can do many things, and I'm sure we can do many things too, but I don't know. We have to put priority. Huh? Meditation. Or maybe we can do both, or meditate and then do it a little bit, a spare time or something. It depends on the availability over there at Supreme Master TV, okay?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
I don't know how you manage to do this and that and others, you know. I'm not going to keep contacting you with all that. If you want to do it, you have to do it alone, be independent. Understand?
Yes, Master.
I will put more time for meditation now. Many things we can do, of course, you know, write a book and write a... drama again, you know. And make a King and Co. second or third or fourth, fifth. We can do forever, you know, but let's meditate, huh?
Yes, Master.
I think we have done a lot. We could do forever, of course. But let's meditate, huh?
Mm.
Yes, Master.
Okay, and do what you can, just a small here and there, all right? Yeah?
Mm.
Yes, Master.
What else? What else? Anybody else?
I think that's it, Master.
Yeah. Ho!
Is there any other questions?
Yes, Master.
We have one.
Oh, Master, I just wanted to tell a story. There's some dogs that stay with us, and one, his name is Polito, he's a black dog, and I asked him one day, are you Master's representative? And he gave me his paw.
Oh.
And he doesn't normally do that. I just thank you for sending them to be with us.
Yeah.
That's cute.
They understand everything. I told you.
Yes, they do, Master.
I told you, yes. Because he's vegan, you know, so he's also a representative of our group. Huh?
Yes, Master.
Of his master, whatever he called me. The dogs understand everything. Yeah. Yeah. Anything else? Any story? Any question? No, huh? The people from Europe, are you going back to Europe or are you going to stay there? Like Sonia?
I'm not sure, Master.
Sonia or Choco and Olivia?
Not sure, Master. We're not sure.
Oh, okay.
We don't really know, Master.
But we'd like to see you.
I thought you want to go back to work or something.
No.
No, Master.
The other Choco. The pink Choco.
No, I don't want to.
Not you, the pink Choco.
Half-time, yeah, part-time maybe.
What do you want to do, Sonia? And the one next to you, for example, tell me.
I would like to see you, Master, if possible.
Okay, we heard that all day already. Sonia, what I mean before that, what is it that you want to do?
I have no idea.
No idea?
No, I'm free actually, so I have nothing to pay. And I have my sister, she's paying
okay.
me.
She's paying you? Why?
No, I mean for extra extra expenses.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, good, good. So. Okay, okay. I could have all of you, I don't mind. It's just I don't know where to put you, truly like that. You will be all breatharian, right?
Right, Master.
Oh, we can try it, you know, together, you know? Like, watarian, juicetarian, whatever. And there's maybe just room to sit. Sit only. Maybe? They have luggage. They have luggage, they have all kind of stuff. Men with shaving cream, and, you know? Shaving apparatus, yeah? And women have their other things. Wow. When you come here, I think you'll be stripped of everything. You can't just wear a suit like that. There's nowhere to hang your suit.
We don't need them, Master.
Ah, it's very easy, you know? They don't need luggage. We do like the ex-owner of this house. You're the ex-owner of this house, they're nudist. And you are Buddhist. Yeah. Or we all go to the place in the other side of the country, and they have a nudist camp. And it's hot, it's warm all year round. You don't need much, no? Maybe just a thin shawl, you know, when you go out shopping. They have shopping in there. They have post office. They have everything in there. I never been there. I don't even know where it is. I just heard they told me like that. Oh, we can find out, of course, ne? No big deal. Mm. That's a big good question, ne? Yeah. If we don't eat anything and we don't wear anything, then what is it to worry about? Well, you can wear minimum, you know, like like the yogi in India or like Mahatma Gandhi. Yeah. The moment you enter the gate, I will hand you a loincloth. Man and woman alike, that's it. And I will assign to you like 3 bricks of a space. 3 or 4 bricks each, then maybe enough. Yeah? Okay, I don't even know about that. We will see. All right? Yeah.
Yes, Master.
You don't have work there anymore? No? It's all clean cut, done? Really? Just like that?
There's still a little bit. Like the archiving,
There's still a bit
the website
work left to finish off.
But not everybody, Master.
Why?
Like some people, like the translators, for example, are already free.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Some script writers also.
Okay, who are free? Raise hand. The European, maybe? Yeah? Who are free? Who could be free? Like yesterday. How many there? Stand up. I can see better when you stand up. First the woman. The woman first. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're all European?
No.
No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yeah.
Okay. 7. And men? 7, right? Yeah. Men, how many free? Count for me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7?
7, Master.
7 and 7? Wow.
7 and a half.
7 and a half.
Choco is not sure.
Why 7 and a half?
Charles I still have some work, Master.
Oh, you still have some work? Oh, okay. How? What kind of work you have?
Archiving.
Mm-hmm. For how long?
Like shows to the website. Maybe 3 weeks.
Oh, I see. It's not long. Okay. Well, at least like that, don't have to like everybody come all at once and scare the house. Okay. And everybody else busy, right? Doing something? Yeah? Like
yes.
What?
Master, I still have some weeks of work, like 3 weeks or 1 month worth
to
work.
Do what? Work. Do what?
Editing shows and DVDs and other things.
Oh, okay. Gabisco, yes. Good. Any more question and request or story? If not, then I go sleep. Huh?
Master, we want to thank you again from the bottom of our hearts for all the support and love you gave us through the years. And just for your love, that's what I want to say.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you also. Thank you to you, all of you.
No, Master, we're the ones that are thankful, and this is really like a once-in-a-million-lifetime opportunity for all of us to be able to have this chance to work with you. And yesterday you were saying that it was your privilege, but actually the privilege and honor is all ours, and we're just forever grateful for this chance.
Okay. Thank you. But I also think it's also my privilege, because some of you are very talented also. You wrote nice things, and you work very hard, and you try your best, you know, and you sacrifice your time, yeah, for the love of all beings. And it's also my privilege, okay, to work with these kind of people.
Thank you, Master.
You don't find these kind of people all over on the street. Yeah, in the world. Yeah, you're also special. And it's, I really meant it when I say it's my privilege to work with you guys. Not just you here, but I mean all the staff around the world as well. Yeah, I'm privileged to have people with such dedication, even though we are just a small group, but we did a great job. Yeah. I mean, generally, I am very proud of what Supreme Master Television staff around the world and you guys are doing. Okay? I think you have talent and you have heart. You have good heart. You really want to offer something to the world and you try your best. So I really am proud. Okay?
Thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
All right.
So I see you sometime soon. Yeah? Okay? You know already that I do things now according to heaven's will as well. I don't want to like dictate the whole universe or the whole system in case it's make it chaotic. Yeah? Understand?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
All right. Thank you, and I go sleep now. I hope I can sleep tonight.
Thank you, Master. Thank you, Master.
Again, it's 4 o'clock, and I'm not sleeping yet. Wow. Okay. Love you guys. I love you very much. I'm sorry we had to stop Supreme Master Television. Also, for me, I missed something. Yeah. I feel like I miss something. When it's there, you don't feel like anything much. But when it's gone, you really appreciate it. You know, like tonight, the TV just gone black, huh? I mean, even Hotbird gone black too, and Astra, and we scramble for every Hotbird and every Astra, but still doesn't come in. Only on the computer now, yeah, on the internet. So normally,
I will skip the intro and outro, you know, like we have how many IPTV network in Mongolia, how many, I skip that, I don't look, because I saw it already, you know, I know that. But today, even that, it sounds very sweet, and I will listen to that as well. You understand?
Yes, Master.
Because now is the last time, and I really want to watch it the whole night and listen to every last word ever. When it's gone black again, I don't know how I feel again. Okay, guys, I love you really very much.
We love you, Master.
We love you, Master.
Love you, Master.
Okay, love you.
We love you.
See you. Ciao, ciao.
Following are some additional viewers' comments received after Supreme Master Television's final broadcast.
We also received email heartlines. This one is from Italy. I discovered Supreme Master TV only a few months. I immediately liked how it is a television program that is really useful. Thanks to you, I decided to become vegan. Thanks for all the programs you broadcast that touched my heart and my soul. I really miss not being able to follow the broadcast of Master Qinghai, and I am missing her so much. I wish you happiness and health, Master Qinghai. I hope that heaven blesses you always in your mission, gives you strength and health to address difficulties in the way, and protect you always. For this new year, 2012, I hope to have initiation. I am sure, with the blessing of the Master, we will get it. Thanks, Master Qinghai, for giving me the opportunity to learn. It helps my soul and my heart to be more happy. With all my love and heaven's blessings, Francesca Ambrose.
This next email is from Mr. Whale Ajaline from Jordan. Hi, I don't know what to say. I'm really speechless. There are no words that can describe what I feel. 5 years of all memories. Really, I don't know what to say. All what I know is that I open the website every day and many times looking at, searching in, watching programs and cry. It wasn't an ordinary channel. My feeling is that all his staff is my family. Is there anyone who can handle the absence of his family?
Ms. Helen Koo from Malaysia wrote, "What a sad news to know that Supreme Master TV is no longer available. For the past 5 years, we have been switching it on every night till the next morning of, even afternoon, no matter we are watching it or not. Please don't give up. Continue. We must not falter against any obstacles. As Master always told us to be brave, to walk the noble way, then why is that Supreme Master TV stopped its program? Don't stop. Continue to broadcast the live TV. We love Supreme Master Qinghai. Please continue."
We have a note from Ms. Odonchimek from Mongolia. "Thank you, Master, and all the staff of Supreme Master TV for all your effort and dedication in these years. I'm very sad. Can't stop crying as I watch the final live broadcasting, but you are always in my heart. I will watch further the archive programs. Thank you, all of you, from my heart."
Another email reads, "Hello, it is so sad to know today is the last day of Supreme Master TV broadcasting. I learned a lot during the past year through watching it. Could you tell me why it is closed? Thanks, Jun Meng."
Here's an email from the UK. "I love Supreme Master TV, Supreme Master Qinghai, the presenters, the programs. You helped me become veggie and discover my true self. You may not realize how much of a gap is in all of our lives now the programs have stopped. I miss you all already. Please tell me why Supreme Master TV is no more. I love you all. I love this planet. I love all life. Please reply. Mike, Wolverhampton, United Kingdom. P.S. My deepest regards and love. Kisses and hugs."
He also wrote another email addressed to Supreme Master Qinghai. "Dear Supreme Master Qinghai, please don't leave us now. We all need you so much. I know most of the world didn't listen to you, but some of us did. What can I do to help? We need you and your love till the bitter end, which I think will be soon. With all my love and light, Mike Wolverhampton, United Kingdom. Kisses."
From Facebook, Bluesy Blue wrote, I will miss you so badly. I only found out about your station when I got my satellite set up to receive foreign channels here in the UK. You spread very wise words about veganism, and I hope your presence actually did change people's lives, as you have mine. Bless you all. I hope one day you can come back to TV. Kisses. On Twitter, Leo Shodas wrote, "Why did you stop the broadcasting?"
Danielle Bluestone wrote on Facebook, "The perfect alternative to fear-based media news."
Debbie Frayen also wrote on Facebook, "I hope we all realize that no other channel in the world brought and united so many different countries, cultures, and faiths, and provided subtitles to unite us all as one. We should be uniting for it to continue ad infinitum. Shame on us all if this is the end of noteworthy news with positive, uplifting news on a daily basis. Shame on us all if we are not prepared to see and hear the truth concerning that desperate situation our beautiful planet is in, due to the ignorance and heartlessness of our own kind. Who else is going to greet you in the morning with, 'Hello, harmonious viewers,' or 'charitable viewers,' or 'gentle viewers,' etc., with beautiful gentle tones and genuine peaceful vibes? Nobody is, because it's not available anywhere else. And now it's gone because everyone else who didn't bother watching this channel aren't into incredible, open-hearted, peaceful, loving, authentic, informative, entertaining, amazingly hopeful, and educational TV programming. That's what Supreme Master TV gave, 100%. Supreme Master Qinghai is a colossus of love, an inspirational genius, and all her staff are too. And I miss this TV channel. I don't miss any other channel. 7 a.m. is noteworthy news, 7:30 is vegetarianism, the noble way of living, and 8 is between master and disciples. 9 is always about animals or the planet, then there's the sweet little charmers that play in between, the private video recordings of Supreme Master Qinghai. Then after a beautiful greeting from our best friends, there's the endless round of satellite and cable news, followed by urgent, relevant, and inspirationally hopeful rescue and devotion to humanitarianism. Then more inspired education about music and people and places and cultures all over the world. So diverse that it makes you wonder if you've ever known anything at all. Then noteworthy news again, and then wow, or words of wisdom. And the in-betweeners are 5-minute clips to give us all a genuine view of what human life is and what we can do to make everything turn out okay if we just try. Obviously, I miss it, and I want it back. It's even more essential as the days go by, not less. And if I was a billionaire, I'd be putting my bucks where my heart is and insisting it return. Or better still, the powers that be. It'd be back now, right now. So we'd just be in time for noteworthy news and then maybe enlightening entertainment. Or was it the poetry program because it's Saturday evening? Namo Buddha, Namo Amitabha, Namo something, Namo something else. Going to the pure Buddha land. Love that song.
The following is an email from France. "Dear Master, it's with tears and gratitudes that I'm writing to you today. When I woke up in the morning, I turned on my TV to view Words of Wisdom on Supreme Master TV. I was so disappointed when I heard that that was the last day. I discovered this amazing channel in 2008. There was no sound, but many writings. I couldn't understand. What was it? Then came 2009, when my brother subscribed to DSTV. I went one day through the public channels and discovered Supreme Master TV. From the first time when I heard Supreme Master Qinghai's message, I was profoundly touched inside me. It was like that's what I was searching, that's what I needed, and what all the humanity needs. So we became friends with Supreme Master TV. Master's voice and all the programs are good. Every time I could see that there are so much good things to do on Earth, there are so much to do. Through Supreme Master TV, I got the contact of the Johannesburg Center, and I had been initiated in 2009. It is through this amazing channel, by God's grace. I'm sure that other human beings come to you via Supreme Master TV. Thank you so much for all you are doing for us. Please help me on my way to sainthood to improve my spiritual practice. Thanks to you, Master, and to all Supreme Master TV staff. May you give me enough resources to continue to see Supreme Master TV online. Sincerely, it is a powerful instrument. Best wishes to all. God bless you. Happy Vegan New Year. Landry Paul Muteba Kazadi.
The Vegan Option, which is an internet radio channel, wrote on Twitter, "Sorry to hear you're ending production and thanks. Big question, why?"
Another person on Twitter named William from Japan wrote, "Supreme Master Qinghai Television ceases live broadcasting today. Will a visit to Loving Hut be the same?"
Jeffrey Kahn from Northern Ireland also wrote on Twitter, "Supreme Master TV, there is no media agency I can trust. Major loss for many of us. Eternally grateful to all involved." Victor Truviano, Dr. John Hagelin, Jericho Sunfire, Marcus Rothkranz, just a few of my favorite guests on the channel. Not forgetting Stephen Harefield and his teachings on karma and revelations regarding Christ in India.
Here are some more Facebook messages. Master Akahi, a breatharian from Ecuador, wrote, "Thank you for your love and dedication. You have touched the planet with divine messages of peace, compassion. We are one, body of light, consciousness, sound. The essence of Supreme Master TV is always with the humanity. Eternal love."
LH Friends Only posted, "Oh why? It's such a wonderful programming. It's been informational and uplifting. Thank you for your broadcast, but I feel so deeply saddened today about this news. We truly need more programming like this in our world than the violence and meaningless rubbish that boggles the mind with nothingness. This was great programming with complete substance. Namaste."
Christina R. Cahill wrote, "Oh, I feel so sad. I loved that channel. So positive and uplifting. Just what we need in this world. I am glad the content will still be up. That is good. I'm hoping for another reincarnation of it. Love to all." Vegan radio host Bob Linden wrote the following Facebook message. "It's a little hard for me to see the keyboard through my tears, as I find this to be a sad surprise, having come to admire Supreme Master Qinghai and Supreme Master TV in such a special way over the past 5 years. The love that Supreme Master Qinghai and her disciples have demonstrated for animals and the devotion to expressing it through the wonderful programming on Supreme Master TV are unparalleled. There are far too few expressions of that love in the media, as Supreme Master TV and my radio program, Go Vegan with Bob Linden, have stood alone together in that mission. I want to thank Supreme Master Qinghai and Supreme Master TV for the frequent coverage of my radio program and vegan events. The interviews in which I have appeared on Supreme Master TV, and the interview with Supreme Master Qinghai on my radio program. I thank you for the wonderful award presented to me, which I share with all vegans for being shining world heroes. And I thank you for recognizing and vocalizing the nobility of veganism and promoting and encouraging it. I thank you for the climate change conferences, the disaster relief, and Loving Hut, and other vegan restaurants worldwide, showing how delicious vegan can be. And I thank you for the caring and compassion that you have brought to the world through Supreme Master TV and your great efforts. Thank you for loving animals as much as I do, and for trying to save these wonderful, beautiful, innocent creatures from the violence and brutality they suffer, becoming meat, clothing, laboratory experiments, and entertainment. Thank you for making the world a better place. Wishing you peace, love, health, and happiness. Bob Linden, GoVeganRadio.com."
Mia Kantz posted, "Sad, I just found Supreme Master Television this year. Many blessings on your journey.
Alessio Laura from the United Kingdom wrote, Oh no, but why? I loved your channel and the video recipes from around the world. So inspiring. I hope one day you'll come back. Kisses.
Alexandra Paul Burton from Calgary, Canada expressed, I am so sad.
Konstantin Vo from Moscow, Russia shared, Thank you, love you, miss you.
From Ireland, Kaz Keon wrote, Thank you, Supreme Master TV. I've been vegan for many years, but through watching your television channel, I found an inner peace. Why did it close down? Kisses. I've Googled it. I've asked on forums, why did the channel close down? Does anybody know? Was it a financial reason? Or any other reason? It's a real tragedy it closed down. Sad face.
Here we have another Facebook message. It's from Amanda Rootsy from Australia. Thank you for all your heavenly work. We will miss Supreme Master TV dearly.
From India, Nuwan Danushka writes, Great, I love this TV. May Noble Triple Gem bless your dear Supreme Master Qinghai. Onan Derila from Mongolia shared, Dear Supreme Master TV team, I really miss you guys on TV. Every time when I come back to my home after stressful busy work, I was very happy to see you guys shining and loving faces. Thank you very much for what you have done for the sake of the planet. I'm very proud of you guys and love you so much. Love, love.
Natalia Briancev from Spain expresses, Thank you for all you have done. Be blessed with everlasting divine peace and love.
All the way from Indonesia, Januarius Beni Christiawan, from the depths of my heart, thank you. Thank you and thank you. Katia Maro, who is originally from Portugal and currently living in South Africa, wrote, I love being able to tune in throughout the day, watching change my and my family's life.